Hi, this is Marek from Tryb Solo, and today I'd like to show you something different than normally. Today we won't have any board games here, but I have some really cool wooden puzzles created by EscapeWelt, and thanks for sending these puzzles for review. And you may wonder, why am I showing you wooden puzzles instead of board games with solo mode? First, because you can play or, you know, have fun with this puzzle solo. But most important, it has some connections to board games that may not be quite obvious when you first think about it. There are a lot of games like card games, or, you know, maybe not board games, but usually card games, that use some escape room type of puzzles. There's this exit series of games, it's quite popular. You have Escape Tales from Board and Dice, and there is this Escape Room series in Poland. And usually when you get these games, you get a small box with some cards and, you know, cardboard, maybe some small wooden elements, and you have to solve some kind of puzzles. You have to find clues, you have to find solution in order to win the game. But it's all quite abstract, because you use cards and you use, you know, some cardboard tokens, and that's basically it. And it doesn't really have any connection to a real life experience of an escape room. And with EscapeWelt, they change it a little, because as you can see probably already, you have some cool big wooden objects. And the idea here is that you have, I will show you in a second how they look like. For example, this one here. This one is called, it's called House of the Dragon. And this one has some kind of oriental vibe. And you have this cool wooden object. And your task is to open it and to get inside. How you do it is up to you. You have some clues, you have some, usually you get a small, you can say maybe not a rule book, but a small booklet that contains some background story, because always there is a story connected with all the puzzles. Some are like Egyptian theme, this pyramid here, or the oriental one. You have space box, you know, orbital box, they are like space themed, and you have this Fort Knox box, it's like a, you know, breaking into a bank. And your goal is to open it, and sometimes in this booklet you will find some clues, sometimes you have clues hidden somewhere on the object itself, and you have to solve it, and it's really, really fun. And I will tell more in the summary part of this video, but it's really cool to feel a real physical object in your hand, because in all this escape room type of games, you only get cards, and okay, they will make your brain, you know, working, and it's a good exercise for your brain, but you don't have anything physical. And here you have a physical wooden object, and you have some, you know, parts that you can pull, or some kinds, some elements that you can rotate, like you have some parts where that can be rotated, and sometimes you have to pull something, push something, open something, slide something. It's really, really fun. EscapeWelt creates a lot of these puzzles. I will leave a link in the description of this video. It's hard to show you how it exactly works without spoiling anything, because if I will show you how to open all of these puzzles, you will have no fun by doing it by yourself. So I will in a second show you with this pyramid here what I have in mind when I talk about sliding, pushing, and, you know, opening this puzzles. So I will show you how it works more or less without trying to spoil too much. This is the quest pyramid, nice box, and what you can see when you open it. When you open it, you will get some booklets. You will get the puzzle itself, and here are some booklets. You can see some other, you know, puzzles from EscapeWelt. This is their whole catalog, and you also get some story about this particular puzzle. It will get you into the mood, and as you know, it's all about solving the puzzle, but it's always fun to see what it's all about. You also have some rules of the game. They tell you more or less how to start solving it. So you have this, and your task is to open it. And if you look carefully, you will see that there are some elements that can be rotated. For example, here you have some sliders on this side that you can slide, and you have the bottom of this puzzle, and somewhere here are some clues, and you will have to find it. For example, I will show you just the beginning of the puzzle without trying to spoil too much. You have the arrow that points to something like this, and now you can look at the puzzle and try to locate something that looks similar to the clue. We have something here that looks a little similar to the thing shown on the bottom, and let me push it. If I push it, something comes out. Whoa! And this is something that might give you clue to the next part of this puzzle. If you look closely, you have some line here and something that is divided in the middle, and if you push it back, you will see a number, and this number is 3. So it may give you some hint what to do next. If you look at the bottom of it, you will see something that is similar to the symbol that we have seen a second ago, and if you, for example, cover half of this, you will see some numbers like 3, 6, 1, 4, and you have to do something about it. Maybe you will find numbers that you have to set here in order to, you know, push or pull some other part of it. And this is how you continue. This is how you have to solve the puzzle. And when you solve everything, you will be able to open it, and you will find some special object that is hidden for you inside. So this is more or less how it works. I don't want to show you the whole puzzle and the whole solution, because if you get this pyramid and it's really, really cool, you will don't have any fun. So I don't want to spoil it. So let's go to the summary. So now you have a basic idea how it works, as you have seen with the example with the pyramid. I would like to show you the other puzzles, because we have House of the Dragon, the one that you have seen, the more oriental one. Let me put it back in the box. Okay. There is a space box, and as always, you get the small booklet, and you get the puzzle itself. And this, you know, space box, the name is really proper, because it looks like a box, and you can already see that there are some elements that can be, you know, pulled and pushed. This is how the space box looks like. Some of the puzzles are more complex, some are less complex. I think my favorite one is the pyramid here, because it's, for me, it was the most intuitive to, you know, to solve. And some of them are quite complex, like this Fort Knox Box Pro. This one was quite complicated. There are a lot of puzzles that you have to solve on each side of this puzzle. And this one was on a Kickstarter recently, and this was one quite complicated. And there is also orbital box, and it looks a little similar to space box, like this. They are really well done, really cool. And what I really like is that even though they are, you could say that they are, you know, quite similar to each other, the puzzles are not similar. Of course, if you have finished at least one of the puzzles, you get an idea how they work, so it might be easier to solve next puzzles from EscapeWelt, but you always will be surprised. And in one of the boxes you had even some dexterity elements, but you have some metal ball inside and you have to roll it through a maze, and sometimes you have mirrors that you have to find, and if you look at some things in the small mirror you will see the solution to some of the puzzles. It's really fun, and I really like the idea of having a physical object in your hands. It's fun, it's cool. I would really love to see a collaboration between EscapeWelt and some board game publisher, because it would be so cool to, you know, have a game where you have, like, let's say a regular board game, adventure game for example, and at some point you have a riddle that you have to solve, but it will not be in form of cards, but in form of a, let's say, even small wooden puzzle like this. It would be so cool, because with cards and cardboard you have to imagine everything, and here you can really, you know, slide something, rotate something, push something. It's really fun. And I think it's also a great you know, gift idea for someone who loves escape room or puzzles or anything. You can even use it to hide something inside, because a cool thing is that in the booklet you have a QR code in every of these puzzles, and if you scan it, it will open a website where EscapeWelt gives you a solution how to open a specific puzzle. It's helpful if you are stuck at some point and you really have no idea how to solve it. You can check the solution on their website. It's not always the full solution, but you have some specific steps, so you can just look at some specific, you know, moment, and then you can continue by yourself. But you can buy it, you can open it, you can hide something inside with the help of the solution. You can put it back together, because this is not a, you know, legacy type of puzzle. You can always, when you solve it, you can put it back together, and you can give it to someone. So someone will find something inside, like, I don't know, engagement ring, for example. It would be really a cool idea to hide some, you know, something inside and gift it to someone else. And this person will have to open it and find the you know, the object that you have hidden inside. So it's really, really fun. As I said, I will leave links in the description of this video. You can check EscapeWelt website. They also have an Instagram page where they post a lot of photos. As you have seen, this video may be not board game related today, but these puzzles are really fun. And thanks for watching, and thanks for staying with me. Visit me on Instagram, visit me on Twitter, and visit me on Facebook. I will leave links in the description of this video. Click the like button if you like this video, and subscribe to my channel. See you next time. Thank you. Bye bye.